Very excited to be here for the global premiere of part two of Master Xuan Hua's biographical film. 我们今天聚会又难得全世界第一次有机会看到正法西传玄化上人把正法带到西方第二期全世界的佛教徒 So because this is also the time for our weekly turning of the Dharma wheel of the Avatamsaka, we thought we would combine the two events and make this the very first time that there has been a cinematic Dharma lecture with Master Hua as the topic. 还有呢，因为今天晚上刚好是我们转法轮讲经说法《转华严经》的时间。 所以呢，我们就把两个法会合并在一起，第一次来听经可以看电影，代表正法西传。All right, I'm going to share my screen, and it is time to request Dharma. So here we are, and our Dharma requesters are ready to begin. Please go ahead.
Om Ching Da De Sheng Ting Wei Ci Fa Hui Ji Qie Zhong Sheng Qing Zhuan Miao Fa Lun Jiao Dao Wo 我们如何了生脱死离苦得乐速证无生。Will the Sangha with great virtue, out of compassion, for the sake of this assembly and all living beings, please turn the wonderful Dharma wheel to teach us how to live suffering and attend bliss and end birth and death and quickly realize number.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa.
Homage to the blessed, noble, and perfectly enlightened one.
Homage to the blessed, noble, and perfectly enlightened one.
Namo sadanto suchedoye alahadi samyao samputoshi.
Namo sadanto suchedoye alahadi samyao samputoshi.
Wushang shen shen wei miao fa. 百千万劫难遭遇，我今见闻得受持，愿觉如来真实意。Supreme and wondrous Dharma, subtle and profound, rarely is encountered, even in billions of eons. But now we see and hear it, and accept it reverently. May we truly understand the Buddha's actual meaning. 好的，那我们还要。 Acknowledge country. The Pomo people practice spiritual connections to the earth and to all creation here in Yokeo, Deep Valley, Yukaya area, for tens of thousands of years. Today, we acknowledge them as traditional custodians and original storytellers of these lands. We offer our respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging, and to all First Nations people whose sovereignty was never ceded. 就说我们恭敬地承认，Pomo人是我们寺院所在地的传统叙事和守护人。我们向过去、现在和未来的长者们致敬，并且向所有未曾放弃主权的第一民族原居民，主敬。All right, the Dharma request is complete. On with the film. Locke and Jerry, over to you.
佛教就是智慧教，也叫众生教，因为佛呀和众生是一体的，是没有分别的。
There, I had never met anyone like the master, and I haven't since.
他说，我必须要说真话，你不喜欢听，我一样要说。他就是这个应该说硬骨头的一个人。I
wrote all my friends and said, I found this great enlightened Buddhist master in San Francisco. You should just drop everything and come here so that you can meet him too.
And I felt what I saw just from the back of him was someone who was extremely virtuous. So I trusted him and I stayed.
But in the early days of Gold Mountain, before Swamphacham, a lot of our translators were not very good. They were learning themselves, so they were having a tough time translating the meaning.
So he said, we really need to establish schools. Wherever I have a monastery, I want it to be a school.
He was very clear in starting the schools that people of any religions were welcome.
Chen上面说，那我为什么这样子欢迎你？因为在我心目中，
我有耶稣这种大博爱的精神，不排斥，我们不争了。所以我呀，发了一个很愚痴的愿，我这个愿就是愿意啊，把我的一生乃至于生生世世所应该呀得到的好处，我愿意呀把它
布施给尽虚空遍法界所有的众生。各位观众，晚上好。那今天呢，我们还是继续访问宣化上人。宣化上人您好。
那么这样呢， 我就对我母亲要求，我要去做老道或者当和尚。我母亲就说，你要出家，我不反对，可是我有一个条件，你要等着我死了之后你出家，才可以。我的师父是上长下智老和尚。 我以前对父母很不孝顺的，很不听话的，令我父母操了很多心。由这个之后嘛，我就发心，天天给父母叩头。我觉得世界谁值得我恭敬的，我就向谁叩头。在那时候叩头以后，又想呢， 所有的世界恶人我也向他们叩头，为什么向恶人叩头呢？我希望他们改恶向善。我说我母亲呢刚刚死，我不忍心呢离开她这个尸体，我要在这儿陪陪母亲。
苏州灵山呢，那时候啊，本来想要在那儿再住多一个时间，以后嘛，因为有特殊情形呢，我就到广东，来见这个虚云老和尚。 在六榕寺呢，住的时候，以后嘛，就又一路一路，走到香港。就在香港芙蓉山有观音洞，观音洞里头啊，什么都没有，也没有一张桌子，也没有一张椅子。 坐的时候就在那个墙上那个石头上坐。I
would like to invite Madalena to come forward, take the microphone, and say a word or two about our Dharma friends. And maybe say a couple
words in Cantonese. I'm very happy to be here. 我爸爸呢，就是因为第一次师父在香港地区讲经，讲地藏经，讲完地藏经呢，他就觉得师父呢，是一个很值得他去敬仰的一个法师。
我初時我哋都唔係對佛教完全懵，即係香港人講叫懵查查，唔知道係乜嘢嚟嘅，咁啊覺得佢係一種好迷信。我細路仔就喺香港做睇到啲廟啊，成好多嘢，我都覺得佢係一種迷信。
都会引用好多我哋中国嘅呢个文学。咁在我爸爸嚟讲咧，佢就系即系接受以前系接受呢个古时嘅文化啦，所以咧就觉得哇，呢一个和尚咁后生，识咁多关于老子、孟子、孔子所有嘅学识，滔滔不绝关于。
中國嘅文化好好好，你一個大學教授都唔一定有咁嘅學識。佢點你咁識學呢啲嘢？唔係普通人一睇就識㗎。你讀好多中文都唔一定話你睇你就識，有嗰個悟性有成。所以我阿師傅係不了不起，對我嚟講係一個奇蹟嚟。
我爸爸咧就係第一個係我哋屋企第一個咧去皈依佢。 咁所以佢皈依完之后咧，翻到屋企就讲俾我妈妈听啦。佢话我今日啊拜咗一个哇非常之难得嘅一个师傅。我妈妈话：你都70几岁啦，你拜一个师傅系咪仲老过你啊？佢话唔系啊，我个师傅啊，非常之后生，比我哋嗰个大仔仲要后生得多。
差不多上百人来皈依师父，那大家就凑这个钱呢，来请师父过来美国。那个时候呢，那个费用是非常的高，现在来说呢，好像是不是多少钱。那个时候呢，邀请师父来呢，我们要负责他的来回机票，所以好几千块。这是所有的弟子都真的很发心，都。 筹出来这个钱，然后我们请律师呢办这个手续，请师父过去美国。
He looked solider, and he was very, very concentrated, and he completely ignored me when I was walking by him on the sidewalk because he was focusing his attention inward when he was walking, and I thought, this Buddhist monk is not like any Buddhist monk I saw before.
一定要发布实行，佛法呢，就是要人来弘扬。你要不弘扬佛法，那佛法根本也就没有了。不单呢末法，而且就没有法。所以我们现在的人呢，生在这个末法时代，能有一份力量，就想办法来弘扬佛法。
师父贤弘上人接受马来西亚的佛弟子呢邀请来马来西亚访问，所以从1978年呢。 开始师父就率领一团 十人的访问团呢，来到马来西亚访问交流和弘扬佛法。全国访问呢，总共是42天，沿途的到各寺庙访问呢，皈依者总数有大概6000多人，是当时呢创下一个记录。
1981年底啊，那上人呢啊应邀来到台湾参加这个世界僧学大会，所以那个时候我们有机会就遇到上人了，好，那也在那个时候就皈依上人。
我常说，我有一口气的时候，我就要给众生说法，不管我说的好不好，我都要说，甚至没有人听，我也要说，没有人听，我就给这个桌子讲，给板凳讲。
Suffering is a great teacher. And from that, I would say that what I got out of it was the refugees taught me more than I taught them, because there's no way to get close to that kind of suffering without sort of being overwhelmed and learning. And the fact that it took place sort of encapsulated within this Buddhist monastery with these teachings going on right next door in the Buddha Hall. We had Vietnamese boat people come through here, and then later Laotians, and then Khmer people after the Holocaust in Cambodia. And the fact that the master made a city of 10,000 Buddhas available to them was just an incredible act of compassion and awareness.
We're trying to help them adjust to being here and going forward with their lives. But sometimes they would feel like, well, why did I survive and other people didn't? They'd feel guilty somehow, you know? So we really had to try to encourage them, you know, to be positive and to move forward and not be ashamed.
That's one of the greatest experiences of my life. I said it was the best job I ever had. Never have another experience like that. We probably learned more from the refugees than they did from us. But I taught them landscaping and janitorial and ESL, how to go out and find a job, how to shop at Kmart, and a lot of English.
You know, you're trying to help somebody else, but you also, it's a very fortunate opportunity and blessing to be able to do that and just feel grateful for the chance. It probably, for Master Hua, probably thought it would be a great learning experience for all of us and do something worthwhile for our time.
金禅寺每一个人都是不怕苦不怕难不怕没有钱这么样向佛教来迈进所以要把这个全部的藏经都翻译成英文葡萄牙文西班牙文英文法文德文翻译种种的语言文字预备那么像把这个佛教
向世界去发展。
Immerse. Yeah, that's it. Like jumping into the water, you immerse. So we do have English words that work for that.
Subject, he, I think it's Buddha. This is something about Buddha.
It's two syllables. That's why it's kind of a magic word. Did you bless them? Yes, they were blessed. But this is blessed. Okay. Oh, we got on the Vatican's page. Oh, look, my goodness. Here we go. Just, I think master works good. They become masters of that wisdom. Yeah. Do you agree?
You always use the term enter and always understood it. It always...
I'm sorry, I didn't get it.
Yeah, all these years we've always used the word enter into mm-hmm. Buddha's wisdom. Mm-hmm. And I've always understood it. I understood it right away. And to me, it's rather like that. It's rather like entering the ocean, entering the...
那么大家看得出来，佛陀好像有他自己特别的语文嘛，因为我们也不懂得怎么翻呢，所以现在再过30年，我们回来再把原来出版的那个 code， 就是密码，佛教的密码，文字般若应该说是佛教的密码，我们现在又把它拿那个 key 就 decode， 再把它翻译。用多几个字，就用真正的合格一般大家主流的英文，再把它翻译出来。
受英文教育，全部都去上华小，读了6年的中文而已，过后都不讲中文，所以就念起地藏经就很好笑。过后就有一个人很好，有一位佛友就送了一本英文的地藏经，啊，我们就开始就复制了好多好多本，都全家人都是在念那个英文的地藏经。那时候我们就很好奇，哪一个佛堂这么棒会有英文的地藏经，我们就看了那边写万佛圣城 City of 10,000 Buddhas。
在1981年呢，冬天的时候，上人呢回到台湾来呢，这个弘法，非常非常多的人呢在当场呢，就皈依。那个时候哈、啊，有一群人也在里面皈依，可是我们并没有互相认识，我们不知道，是后来才知道的。这一群人呢，是谁呢？法界佛教，这个印经会的这些拓荒者。我看在上人的记录里面呢，就是即使还没有那个印经会的时候，上人已经开始在台湾找人印经了，中文英文的越南文的也有这个欧语系的这个西班牙文的那这个经典方面，像中文方面就是说这个楞严经楞严经浅释、华严经浅释、华华经浅释、金刚经浅释、42章经浅释，上人都说是浅释啦不少。
Hey,
remember first interview with Master Xinhua when I saw in the 1990. He actually gave the money to translate into Polish the Earth Store Sutra. This sutra also deeply influenced me and inspired me, the Bodhisattva Ksitigarbha, Didzang Wangpusa, the Bodhisattva of Great Vows. So I started to copy by my hand his sutra. I bow to each words on this sutra. And for many years, this Bodhisattva was kind of my hero. How it's happened that the guy like me, who lived in Poland, somehow have in heart the strong desire to be a Buddhist monk.
그 능음신주 본문에 관한 책들이 보이더라고 제에게 알려주는 불자들이 많습니다. 많고 그리고 지금 한국의 독자들에게는 한국의 불자들에게는 이런 능음경 선화상인의 능음경 해설서와 법화경 해설서가 아주 쉽게 능음의 도리와 법화를 법화경의 도리를 쉽게 이해할 수 있게 되어서 많은 독자들이 도움을 받고 있습니다.
在努力，对，我还没有完全，实现，因为上人留下法宝实在是太多了。那上人呢，这个涅槃到现在24年还没有做完，因为要从一个一个字呢，就什么誊稿啊，誊写下来，然后再来就是要顺文啊，还要校正啊，然后还要就这个是单单是中文的部分，还要去印刷呢。这个花一些时间呐，因为也是，真的是留下太多的法宝了，是我们修行的指南。
And I remember it deeply resonated with me. After the ceremony of transmission, the five precepts, Rabbi Heng said that after I took the five precepts, it took after 1 year, they are so powerful, so deeply affect us, that after 1 year to be with them, I become a monk. So I said, ooh, this is interesting. Especially the Master Hua's teaching was for me as a mirror. I first time in my life look at in the mirror and I saw the person who I don't want to see. I saw kind of truth about myself. And this truth was not comfortable.
你要想成圣果，必须要守戒律，所以这个戒律也是最重要的。尤其佛在世的时候，以佛为始，佛入涅槃之后，就是以戒为始，出家人呢要严持戒律。所以整个佛法的法身慧命就在戒律上。
在家就是学在家人的五戒嘛，还包括优婆塞戒经这些，然后法师平常也会给我们补充很多这些生活上的这些规矩啊、律仪啊，然后等到出家之后，那学的规矩就更多，就是从沙弥尼的戒开始，就是都会每一个阶段都会有不同的法师指导我们。
训练班是上人很早年的时候成立的，据我所知是1982年就成立了。那主要的目的就是训练出家人和在家人。那在家人的话，很多就是先上了这个在家居士训练班以后就出家了这样子。
So even I said, maybe I'm not ready, but I want to create conditions in my life that if the day will come that maybe I will be ready, I started to see that the cultivation become more and more important in my life. And I started more spend time during the bowing, sitting, or do anything else.
吸引了很多海外的过来出家，你好比说像我们的方丈就是啊，<笑>我们那个像我们最近的一次那个传戒，比丘戒、比丘尼戒，17年的时候，有4位新比丘，4个都是从居士训练班出来的。
所以说，其实我们要学一个法，第一个，你就是要有诚心。你有诚心，菩萨一定会帮你安排。你不要用不正常的手段想要快速的得到它，因为那终究不是你的。上人说，贪心得来的东西是不长久的。僧伽居士训练班，我们都有一些固定的课程嘛。那戒律也是，就是说栽培这些未来佛教人才很重要的一个基础。那上人注重的戒律是跟一般的人是不太一样的，他是直接就是从你的心开始教起。所以其实他上人讲的很清楚，他的六大宗旨基本上就是戒律了。因为这个跟放晚经菩萨戒就很相应，因为菩萨戒完全讲究心地法门。
你有没有违反这条戒律，其实看你的心。
所以所有的出家人必须受过具足戒，也就是啊，一般人所谓三坛大戒，才是一个真正的出家人。
出家修道的人必须要啊尊重这个戒律，你要不守戒律啊，那就不能成圣者。那么专门呢要研究这个戒律，行住坐卧这四大威之中。
对，这三十五，三十五，
它这个山，
对啊，三十五，这是妙趣山嘛，
上
就叫妙趣山。
政府申请推这个帝王宫，就你把它改为建筑用，就改成教育用，
规划嘛，这农业用地啊，不能改的。我会单位争取这个地啊，花了二三十年才争取到，二三十年。
And the sand.
That is a copy of the Buddha Rupa that is at Wat Pananachan. And Ajahn Kavali gave me that just before I returned to Abhayagiri in 2012. The collage there of my teachers.
You have Master Shenhua.
I have Master Shenhua.
And
yeah.
Ajahn Cha and
Ajahn Sumedho. Ajahn Sumedho, Lompa Pasano, Ajahn Amaro. There was a 2003 Shirangama Sutra study class that I was a part of at the City of 10,000 Buddhas.
I remember.
And so that was, it was 9 weeks long, one teacher each time. I think all the teachers had probably met Master Hua, mm-hmm. I imagine. And that really helped to crystallize my decision to go forth. About 1 year ago, there was a fire here and we had to evacuate. And we first got out of here in the middle of the night off to Willits. The whole town was no internet. So people did not know what was going on. So Ajahn Jodipalo, who was leading us, sent a car up. Just, you know, he drove in the truck driving north to get a cell phone signal. Lumpur Pasano said, I've already made arrangements. You should go to the City of 10,000 Buddhas. And we were received very well. It was, especially I'd spent time there before, so to me, I didn't feel so much as a refugee as sort of going home. Uh-huh. And I remember I participated in, I made every 4 a.m. morning chanting session.
Wonderful.
That was just demonstrated the close connection between the two communities.
回答你信天主，信耶稣，回答信佛，回答信穆罕默德。你不论你信什么宗教，你要真正啊了解你的教主创教的精神是什么。你了解你教主创教的精神，那是真正祈祷。 因为那个是上人，他很慈悲，那就把他留下来，他就要我们把他当成是观世菩萨。我们应该要包容其他的宗教，把它汇合在一起。 他们只是现在，他们是在天主教，可是他其实都包括在佛教里面。把自己忘了他，而为一切众生来祈祷。 不是单单这一个世界的众生，所有尽虚空遍法界的众生，都包括在内。你要能这样祈祷，我相信呢，耶稣啊，是欢喜的，天主也是欢喜的，佛也是欢喜的，穆罕默德也是欢喜的，可以说是皆大欢喜。
俺们还仍然呢要记得佛的慈悲，耶稣的博爱，穆罕默德的清真认主。俺们做不论做哪一个宗教的教徒，俺们要做一个教主的好孩子。
Not easy, and it's not simple, that's for sure. And it has no shortcuts, because we are developing the potential of humanity, of being human. And that will take a long time.
We have a very good acceptance rate at good colleges. Every once in a while, we'll get a phone call from officers at the university who are in charge of accepting students. I've gotten phone calls. And they say, you send us a lot of students, so we're going to tell you what we need from now on. And I think they're fully aware of our school now.
I know that when they go out to school, it will be a little difficult.但是呢，因为我们跟着师父的精神嘛，我们就是忘我圣人的家风，我们有什么用什么。然后呢，我们的小孩子他的韧性非常的强，因为他们比外面的孩子能够耐得起那个耐力，还有那个坚韧的力量比别人强，所以最后在外面的学校也都是非常的优秀。
There's a lot more to talk about, especially this studio. This old studio has so much history. When I first came in the studio, it was completely empty. And I mean, really, wall to wall, nothing. And we've done a lot. And over the years, it's gotten dirty, and then it's gotten cleaned out. And now it's coming back. We're DRBU is sponsoring the help clean this thing up and get it really nice. And
this is his mess.
Yeah, I put some color in the middle. Nice. And I'm gonna put like another little bit of color.
And we're really, really happy, both of us, that we were able to teach back then, because that was a wonderful experience.
Yeah.
Really, I mean, it really isn't anything like it, teaching here. You have a lot of freedom, and there's a creative feeling.
Because he saw that the world needed people who had understood the Buddhist principles, and that a lot of the suffering and the disasters in the world came from people's, ultimately it all comes from our minds. So the way to counter that is to have people who are educated in proper principles and who understand
how important it is to work on oneself, do the difficult inner work. And so starting at a very young age with the young children and then moving up every grade and to the university where we can train people who can go out into the world and be examples of how to be good people in the world.
I see Master Hua through the traditions of CTTB. It's the people that knew him that tell me about him. Humboldt students are an idealistic group of students, and they are searching frequently for moral and virtue, and morality and virtue, and spiritual guidance. And so I think that on the whole, they're very positively impressed by what they experience here.
Just because you're spiritual doesn't mean that you're a good person. It depends how you use the inner spiritual and spirit energy, you know, that you you gather, you learn to channel, and then you learn to use. But whether you use it for good or for bad.
做董事会的董事，那时候我也改工作，那时候我变成在一个这个国际顾问公司，做这个帮这个大公司还有政府机关嘛，做这个长期的这个策划工作。后来这个法界大学已经成立很久了，但是希望说能够受到这个美国这个正式的这个认证啊，因为我有这种长途长期筹划的这个经验，从那个我之前的，我想说那谁。那我不做，谁来做？
Everyone, please rise.
Family.
Please welcome our president, Dr. Susan Round.
We have many reasons to celebrate this year. We have just completed our first full year as an accredited university. We have welcomed our first international students. We benefit in countless ways from the members of the monastic community who donate their services as members of our faculty and staff. And I should note here that the faculty and staff who do receive a salary receive far less than they would receive at any other institution, and I know they work far harder. But no matter how challenging the work, like the little blue engine, we think we can, we think we can, we think we can, and we do.
While at DRBU, I also found lifelong friendships, structure, guidance, positive role models from our professors and monastics, and pure wholesome energy that perfumes a consciousness.
西部就是政府按的，有两百所合格的大学，包括Stanford，包括Berkeley，University Washington，UCLA，法界佛教大学，所以这是商人对于教育方面的一个未来的一种眼光，一个愿力，现在今年刚好42年后实现了开花。
Most of the people who come here, you know, you come here to do different things to this place because it's a special place. If we take the time, but it won't happen overnight. But occasionally it shines. It's like the sun catching the shine of a diamond. And it happens. And I think at this point we're in a good position. But we shouldn't rest and say, ah, we made it. Wait. Yeah. We still have a lot to go.
And the master had always been very pure with all of us. He's very, very, he's like a little child in some ways, in that kind of innocence. You know, he was very pure in the way he dealt with all of his disciples.
Just even observing him, you know, day to day and seeing his capacity for compassion, for human-heartedness, that was what I think led people to him. It wasn't an ideology. It wasn't that he was a sage. It was the human quality he brought to the exchange and the care and concern he was able to emanate from his heart.
She carries me to the other. She carries me. She carries me. She carries me.
我可以说如果没有遇见好玄奘上人，我不会现在做寒川佛教的一个出家众。他是真正的实行大道的一个大德高僧。他说我什么都不怕的，我就怕我自己不真。
Who did was very brave. He came to the United States, didn't speak English, and look what he built. Everything that is here, everything that you see here at the City of 10,000 Buddhas or at the other way places, all came from the virtue of this person, all came from his cultivation. It's like, it's a miracle. It's amazing. This one man came and inspired so many people.
When Karmapa, following his Karmapa, when he visited, he praised the master. He said, oh, you have such a big monastery. You have so many branch monasteries all over the United States, overseas. And he goes, you're a great bodhisattva. And the master said, I'm a shaomai. I'm a little ant, a mosquito. And he said, he literally said, I'm waiting for someone in the future to come who has great wisdom.
那上人是一个，他平常就是一个平常的人，可是呢，在平常里面，你有说不出的那种的不平常，我也说不出来，所以有一次跟上人讲了，说即使世界都暗了，那只有上人在呢，那上人你就像那颗明星，我们还是充满希望。
So how did I meet Master Hua? Well, he was there when I was born because he was the person who married my parents. He officiated at their wedding. And I even heard that before I was born, because my parents were very poor at the time, he even gave them some baby equipment. So he was always a part of my life in that way.
When I started telling my story, I mentioned that I came to San Francisco to go to a party. What I didn't tell you is that I dropped out of high school, but I went to nursing. I was able to go to nursing school, and instead of just being a party person, now I'm a professor of nursing. The RN program in the town here is one that I started so that other people could also have that opportunity. And none of that would have happened. None of that would have happened without Sherfu.
I think he also had great faith in us, probably more faith than we had in ourselves, and he believed we were capable of doing great things. And that was very special to have someone so completely believe in you.
He used to just say all the time, just be a good person. No, don't worry about attaining all kinds of states. You know, you begin studying Buddhism and the Buddha's heads are right here. You study it for 30 years and the Buddha's heads are up in the clouds, you know. Don't worry about those things. Just try and be a good person. That's hard enough.
Oh, he's a great teacher. He was a great example for me. It takes a lot of courage to come, start from nothing to something. A lot of hard work. He set the example for us. I just want to carry on his work and see if I can make some kind of contribution.
然后他们没有马上告诉我们他走了，然后就开始叫我们大家都到大殿去集合。那就在那一刹那，那真的是一种心电感应，就一边走就开始哭了，我也不知道为什么哭，然后进去就大家在念佛，我们就很难过这样子了啊，等念完佛他才告诉我们说师父走，然后那个时候我就会觉得说。
I said, I don't always please everybody, but I cannot not speak what's true. And I said, Master Hua, that's why I'm following you. And he took his towel and he whacked me over the head. And he said, don't follow me, follow wisdom. And he walked away. And so while the towel hurt, the teaching was right on. Don't even follow the teacher, follow what the teacher is following. And so in that way, I saw his virtue. He wasn't interested in having disciples cling to him or to worship him or honor him. He wanted them to stand on their own two feet. And when they were able to do that, his job was done and he was gone.
When I first recognized that, one of the thoughts that went through my mind, this is when I had just known him not very long, was how can this be, you know? And I remember sitting on the front steps, looking out at the street, and I remember very clearly thinking, what is wrong with our culture? Here we have this great sage who is probably one of the 3 to 5 great sages on the entire planet, you know? And nobody recognizes him, you know, what is wrong, you know? And that remains a question for me till right now, today.
All right, everybody, what do you think? 大家看完了，你们觉得怎么样呢？ This is a wonderful opportunity, to the very first screening for the whole world of part 2. 大家的意思怎么样啊？你们看完了有什么感想啊？这是第一次。 全世界的佛教徒有机会看到这第二期，这个大法西传。So there's a third part in the works. It's not ready yet. It's going to be in production for some time. And the hope of everyone who put together this film over the years, so many hands, so many hearts, their wish, if I can represent it, is to with this film, help people fa da puti xin, make the great resolve for Bodhi, and take Sherpa's vows and make them your own. What we saw today was the Buddhism in Hong Kong and then Buddhism in America and then around the world. But it is a work in progress, and it requires all of our best efforts. Sherpa would say, try your best. 今天我们看到的香港一部分，然后呢，就是上人把佛法带到西方，还有全世界。第三期呢还在整理，那需要各位的帮忙。那么我相信大家把第一、第二期这个纪录片。 他们的希望，如果我能代表，就是看完了，我们就发大菩提心，就认为上人的愿力也是我们的愿力，我们把这个work in progress 这个工作正在进行了，就把它推翻，把它进自己的心。 那么商人就会自强不息, try your best, make it our own, and make part three into the future our own work. 第三期就变有我们, okay, I see all the comments, that's good. Appreciate everyone's, we're going to save those comments and pass them on. But I'd like to... can we say that the inspiration that you saw was based upon Sherpa's four legacies that we've always put Sherpa's 30 years of work in the body here in around the world, divided into four phases, and you saw them represented here, establishing the Sangha and the way places, translating sutras, distributing them, propagating education at all levels, and advocating interfaith. If you go to drbu.edu, you can find out the ongoing work of Dharma Realm Buddhist University and how you can get involved. If you go to buddhisttexts.org, you can, that's two T's, BuddhistTexts.org. You can find the translations work ongoing. So those are two places. 如果各位想知道多一点，你 www.drbu.edu, drbu.edu, 还有 BuddhistTexts.org, 你就会知道商人那个四大一禅是到现在怎么样进行. Okay, we have to finish before 9 p.m. in California time, so let us transfer the merit. 我们必须要在9点前结束了，那么希望各位可以跟我一起回向功德。Okay, we're going to transfer the merit, so please make a vow, make a wish, however you would like your merit to be transferred, and we appreciate your comments. Look forward to seeing you here again for part three. 好的，那我们现在回向功德了。各位发愿，May every living being, our minds as one and radiant with light, share the fruits of peace with hearts of goodness, luminous and bright. If people hear and see how hands and hearts can find in giving unity, may our minds awake to great compassion, wisdom, and to joy. May kindness find reward. May all who sorrow leave their grief and pain. May this boundless light dispel the darkness of our endless night. Because our hearts are one, This world of pain turns into paradise. May all become compassionate and wise. May all become compassionate and wise. One more. May all become compassionate and wise. Before we end, we will encourage everybody to bow to the Buddhas with us. Mandaja ichi before sambai. How yi wan xin? Ar wan xin? San wan xin? Bow in respect to the Venerable Master. Hada Amitofo, how umadatsuweju, huh? Yeman. Okay, we will end at this point. See you all next week for the regularly scheduled sutra lecture. Amitofo. Bye now.